Hello, you're watching Proactive London. Joining me today is Harry Vafias. He's the founder and the CEO of StealthGas and also Imperial Petroleum. Harry, it's good to speak with you today.
Thank you very much. Good morning.
So, Harry, for those viewers not familiar with the companies, can you tell us more about StealthGas and Imperial Petroleum? Maybe starting with StealthGas.
Yes, I mean, StealthGas was founded in 2005. Enlisted on the Nasdaq in October 2005. I was 27 years old when we listed that company. I got a special award for being the youngest CEO of a US-listed shipping company. That company started with 9 gas carriers. And after some successful equity offerings, the company at its peak had 50 ships. 95% gas carriers and a few tankers. And we became the largest owner of short-haul gas transportation assets. I've been the largest shareholder since the beginning. I still am now. And in December 2021, we decided to spin off the StealthGas for oil tankers into a separate US-listed entity called Imperial Petroleum, ticker symbol IMPP, which has started now its life as a separate entity, separate listed entity, with different shareholders. I am the CEO of both companies. The two companies have a totally different strategy. StealthGas is an LPG gas transporter with emphasis on smaller size ships. Imperial Petroleum is an oil tanker owner, so it transports oil and crude oil and petroleum products with emphasis on both small and large ships. Imperial Petroleum has been doing equity offerings to increase its equity base and therefore its fleet, whereas StealthGas, for the time being, is not doing equity offerings as is large enough, has very low debt levels and can grow with its own means if it needs to. Of course, with the recent developments with Russia and the invasion of Ukraine, this has been an unfortunate event, obviously for humanitarian reasons, but it's been a very positive, has had positive effects for the energy businesses. So both StealthGas and IMPP have been benefiting from these new sanctions on Russian energy companies and on the new trade routes for Russian oil and gas. Day rates for our ships, especially for tankers, have gone up between 500 and 700%. Since the start of the war. And obviously nobody knows what will happen in the future, how quickly this will end, if the sanctions will end or not for the foreseeable future. Therefore, we are in a period where energy is expensive, ships are crucial, ships carrying gas and oil have become very crucial and essential. And of course, rates to charter such a ship have gone up tremendously, which obviously benefits the ship owners, and in our case, both StealthGas and Imperial Petroleum.
So, I mean, with Imperial Petroleum, you said you are still growing this business and raising equity. Equity markets are also going through a turbulent time at the moment. So how difficult is it to raise equity to take advantage of opportunities in the shipping market?
Yes, I mean, just for you to understand the numbers behind it, StealthGas, which is listed since 2005, so 17 years, has a daily average share volume of 150,000 shares. So 150,000 shares of StealthGas are sold on average every day. Imperial Petroleum, which is a company with only 6 months track record, has a daily share average of 45 million shares. So the one company with the very long track record sells approximately 150,000 sales a day. And the other company, which is very fresh and young, without a track record, is selling 45 million shares a day, which actually has become the seventh most liquid stock traded in any US stock exchange. So by being so liquid, obviously there's a lot of interest, especially from retail investors and people that trade on a daily basis. And therefore, of course, the sentiment in the stock markets today is not very good. But if you can tempt the investors to buy shares at a discount to net asset value, then I think that there is lots of demand, and that is how we've done three successful equity offerings for IMPP in the last 6 months.
Where do you see growth opportunities for Imperial Petroleum? Because I presume it will be through acquisitions.
Yes, we want to grow our fleet to about 15 to 20 ships. At the moment, I think we have 8. So we've already doubled our fleet since the spin-off. The spin-off, when we spun off the company in December, it had 4 tankers. Now we have 8. Therefore, we need to buy approximately another 10 vessels to be considered a medium-sized pure-play oil tanker company.
You talked about the benefits that you've derived from the geopolitical tensions at the moment between Russia and Ukraine. How do you see the market fundamentals developing from here, Harry?
Shipping, as you might know, depends on essentially 2 things. One is supply and demand, and the other one is need for oil and need for energy. So in this particular point of time, it looks like all things being very positive for IMPP and StealthGas, but more for IMPP, because on one hand, you have very little supply of ships as the shipyards are full building other types of ships like container ships, for example. Therefore, there are no slots for somebody that wants to build an oil tanker, or he has to wait many, many years before he can take delivery of such a ship. So on one hand, we have a small supply of ships. On the other hand, we have the extreme need for energy now that COVID is slowly, slowly, hopefully dying. And on the other hand, you have the sanctions on Russia, which makes countries that need energy trying to find this oil from further away places, making the necessity for more ships, which are not there. So if you need more ships and the ships are not there, that means that you have to pay more money to get a ship, which obviously in the end of the day is very positive for the companies that own the ships. To give you a real example with numbers, in November last year, an Aframax tanker, which is a medium-sized crude oil ship, was earning approximately $10,000 a day. That ship today, especially if you're willing to load the Russian cargoes, might be earning close to $70,000 a day. So that's 700% up in 7 months. So again, we are not prophets. We cannot predict the future. We don't know when this thing will end. We don't know when the sanctions will be removed from the Russian energy companies. But it seems that they will last. It seems that they will last. So that means for us, better day rates, better profits for a longer duration. Going back to StealthGas, again, because you mentioned our Q1 results. Net income for StealthGas for Q1 22 was up 900% from a loss the equivalent quarter last year to a big profit the same quarter this year. So, you know, numbers talk for themselves, but I'm explaining you the reasons why we see this increase in the numbers. With Imperial Petroleum, we are announcing results in approximately 2 weeks. So we hope to be able to show an improvement on the Imperial numbers as well, despite the fact that the fleet of Imperial is still small in comparison with the fleet of StealthGas, which is approximately 45 ships.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on any new developments, but thank you very much for the update today. It looks like a compelling investment case for both companies. Harry, good speaking with you.
Thank you very much for your time and for your excellent questions.
That's Harry Vafias. He's the founder and also the CEO of StealthGas and Imperial Petroleum.